Hello and fuck cape shit. Welcome to another episode of Shitty Webcomics Weekly, brought to you by our Subscribestar backers. Donate to our Subscribestar, become PayPig on our Subscribestar to get access to the videos they don't want you to see. The mysterious they. What kind of they? Some kind of they. As everyone in the know says, you can find out about it from Shitty Webcomics now, or on Kiwi Farms in 5 years, if ever. So donate to our Subscribestar if you want to know the truth, or don't donate to our Subscribestar if you don't want to know the truth. Or do donate to our Subscribestar if you don't want to know the truth, just don't watch our videos, I guess. Because if you watch our videos, the truth will be raped into your mind, sort of like Counselor Troy, how she was constantly... just constantly getting mind raped all the time.
Constant.
Just, and everyone come, every guest on the Enterprise that showed up mind raped her point or another.
It was a violation.
Yes. It was, in fact, an episode called Violation.
Well, I mean, I'm talking about also the movie Nemesis.
Yeah.
Don't forget, also.
That's right, they mind-raped her in that also. Too. That was so fucking pointless. It was almost kind of great, except that the movie itself was not.
I mean, the movie wasn't that great. At least, it wasn't that great until Discovery.
There was something fucking kind of sad. Yeah, that's right. Nemesis just became better in retrospect. But there's something kind of sad about the older Trek where everyone gets old and it's like, let's give them something interesting or crazy or fun to do. And it's like, yeah, let's have Troy get mind raped again. It's like, eh, just fucking. I mean,
it's like, where do they get these powers from? How the fucking Remans get these powers?
Yeah, otherwise I wouldn't have a problem with it. But it was just fucking stupid. I don't want
to
see
they
fucking
apparently do this and they
old
need to do
Troy.
This.
Yeah.
But they. There's not really any benefits. It doesn't seem to help him. It seems to be giving away the game.
Yeah.
Why'd he do that?
Yeah, and then, yeah, they do that because, oh, it establishes that she can try to sense where they are with their, the perfect clothes. And it's just stupid. Just dumb. In fact, it's a bit new Trek, if anything. Kind of reminds me of Discovery in the worst ways. But you know what's sad, though? Nemesis still had some good aspects to it, but...
First off, no Michael Burnham.
Yeah, exactly. That's fucking...
Michael Burnham, not in the movie.
Anyways, getting to STBR, this will be the last part of sort of this little chunk of videos, where we go into NFT dealer Quark. mentions a going into a history of STBR because I started posting. It was June 15th. Wow, it was that old. June 15th, 2022, when I posted Shitty Webcomics Weekly number 60, STBR part 3, and NFT dealer Quark at Big Lobed Noga says I might have to dig up old stuff from season 1. And so it sort of does and mentions like how STBR basically started. So he says, a short STBR history starring SJW Worf. It all began when a Twitter user who was known as Racist Data. Then this one Twitter user loved his post so much they wanted to respond to his post as another TNG character, thus SJW Worf was born, and the first episodes of STBR began. And here's a picture of Worf just carrying Data. I kind of remember Racist Data, because I remember they would get retweeted a bunch among, you know, actually funny, interesting people on Twitter. And that's when it was harder to get away with that sort of thing. It's a little easier now. Although not foolproof. But continuing. There's, in fact, here, I'll bring this up. Quark says, most of the early posts are lost to history. They got banned and that kind of shit. But SJW Worf posts mostly consisted of Worf going on adventures and letting users know if they had honor. And then here's a bunch of edits of where Worf has a sash with like black power fist, toothpaste flag, fucking no that swastika circle slash. Here's Worf fucking yelling out with the person who was screaming as Donald Trump was elected. Here's Picard and Riker wearing Burger King crowns. Picard is wearing a MAGA hat with a Burger King crown on top of it. There's cans of Dr. Thunder all over the place. And then Worf has the fucking deal with it sunglasses, blunt and thug life hat. And then there's Burger King crowns on the backgrounds as well. Here's from Nemesis, in fact, the disappointing, depressing, kind of bland, lame ending. But all of them are toasting with Dr. Thunder. But there's also fight for suffrage, fight for equality. It doesn't over. Welcome to the new world dystopia. Relax, it can only get worse. Black Lives Matter. Lol. Quark continues saying, the description to these adventures are foggy to me, but he enjoyed creating them. And it's, here's Black Lives Matter, Black Trans Queer Children People's Lives Matter, and this, then there's just Worf out in front with a fucking Black Lives Matter mask on his face. And then here's a picture of Alex Jones and other people with Trump 2020 flags and shit. And then Worf is there also. Just Worf. He's just there. Is he an infiltrator? I don't know. But here's also a furry convention. And then also Worf is there. And then some nerd. It looks like Comic-Con with a bunch of nerds. And then also Worf. It's the same fucking picture of Worf being photoshopped into most of these. Well, these ones anyways. Oh, yeah. And then just here's some more. Here's fucking Trump holding a bat, and at the end of the bat is a can of Dr. Thunder, and then Pence behind him wearing a MAGA hat and a Burger King crown on top. Here's Worf at a fucking drag queen story time, where the kids look horrified, of course. Here's Worf at apparently gay pride parade, something like that. And then Worf standing next to the Joker, Arthur, from the Joker with a bunch of, I was going to say those anime mouse pads with the tits, but it's fucking all furries. And it it looks like a bunch of gay dudes. Why is Worf into that? I don't know. Should we judge him? Yes. Yes, we should. Here's Worf. DS9 Worf, I think, on with Alex Jones, and he's drinking Dr. Thunder with a swirly straw. That's cool. And Alex Jones looks pretty pleased to have him there. That's nice. They actually look pretty nice. Here he is again with Alex Jones wearing like a frog costume while Worf is sitting there just with his Dr. Thunder looking at it. Like, oh no. And then, oh no, fucking Worf looking up at a giant can of Dr. Thunder, and then Worf collapsed on the ground after a bunch of cans of Dr. Thunder fucking fell onto him and crushed his spine.
An extremely dramatic episode where Worf has to face a moral dilemma based on Dr. Thunder.
All because of Dr. Thunder. Look, you can see sometimes the lives that Dr. Thunder has ruined. His story must be told. And then a couple others. I guess those will be a short episode. Maybe it should be. Sometimes we like to pad out the episodes just so they don't seem too short. But the ends with a couple of videos. So I'll just play these videos. In fact, I'll play them and full screen them as we just let them play. Without commentary, because we'll probably get completely drowned out. But here, I'll play this one. This one's 52 seconds, so here. Be this one.
Sa, 飲んでみて。
なんです。
いいから飲んで。 どう？栄養満点よ。
力が湧いてくる。
しっかり栄養は取らなきゃ。一人の生活は良くないわ。いい人はいないの？
私が誰かと付き合うとしたらそれはクリンゴンの女だ。地球の女じゃか弱すぎる。
Yeah, that's just fucking, for some reason, it's the warrior's drink scene from TNG. I think that was from yesterday's Enterprise.
Yeah.
But for some reason, I don't know what fuck, Worf has the space buns, the racist space white person space buns from Animal Crossing that turned into a fucking giant Suju meltdown. A few years ago.
Wait, what was that from?
That I don't know, but for some reason they're photoshopped onto Worf's head, and the whole scene is in Japanese. For some reason,
I missed the fucking what the fucking. You might need to add the context there because I have no idea what the fuck that's about.
Yeah, the space buns. They're like the two Afro puff buns. That was a hairstyle from Animal Crossing. And people, Twitter, SJW, Suju Twitter, had a fucking giant meltdown about it, being like, white people, even in Animal Crossing, they were saying white people shouldn't be allowed to wear that kind of hairstyle because it's for black people only. And it led to a big backlash against them.
Paternalistic whining, and it's also like, it is turning black people into purse puppies.
Yeah, and I think black people, it's like, that's when people realized the critical mass had finally overflowed, and people were like, you know what, I don't fucking care about fucking
woke leftism. Yeah. I don't care about black people.
I think even black people were like, even I am tired of caring about black people. Black people were getting N-word fatigue.
They're moving on. From N-word fatigue to straight-up N-word exhaustion.
Yes. I have no idea why it's photoshopped onto a Worf's head as he drinks a fucking Dr. Thunder that Guinan brings him, or why it's dubbed into Japanese, or what's with the goofy background music that sounds like fucking some kind of Spanish bullfighting Japanese music.
I guess Japanese, if it's in Japanese, it's more fash wave.
Yeah, I suppose. You know what? I think you got a point there, perhaps. And as a last thing.
Fash wave, which as we also already know, stands for fascist wave.
Yes. As opposed to just fash, which as opposed to fashion. Even though, I guess, do they mean the same thing? Perhaps they're fashionable because it's all about the cool clothing, right? Isn't that what the whole point of it was? It was about cool clothing and style.
But no, because it's not a fashion. It's here to stay.
Fascia means connective tissue, by the way. So that's what, that's actually... No, what,
that's where fascists...
That's where fascism comes from. It's about connected, being connected with your local community. It's positive and happy, isn't it? Is that what fascism means? What does fascism mean? I don't even know. Nobody does. Anyways, so Quark ends.
It's because of the bundle. It's because a bundle of dicks.
A bundle of tightly wrapped dicks. We got a full tank of dicks. Anyways, Quark says, NFT dealer Quark specifically says, STBR season one, so many gone. Worf and I had opened a bar, and then he got suspended and left me running it by myself, so I just became an art dealer. That's the short story of how STBR was created. Glad I could post the few Worf posts I could find. Hope this helps on your next video. Which took a while, but we did get around to it, and I'm glad we were able to get around to this.
We never forget, even though we often forget.
We certainly don't forgive, of course, because people don't deserve it.
But we don't forget forever.
Not forever, just for a long, prolonged, extracted period of time. But anyways, here's the last video. This one's a minute and two, and it's, I hope I don't get struck for the Cheers theme song. If I do, I'll have to blank out the audio. So if the audio is blank, it's just the theme song from Cheers.
The original, or the full?
No, it's just the TV one version. It excludes the transphobic part. It's about your husband wants to be a girl, and that saying that like it's a bad thing
because
it is. Yes. So here I'm just gonna play this for the last minute of the show right now. So here I'm hitting go.
Making your way in the world today takes everything you've got. Taking a break from all your worries sure would help a lot. Wouldn't you like to get away? Sometimes you want to go where everybody knows your name, and they're always glad you came. You want to be where you can see our troubles are all the same. You want to be where everybody knows your name. You want to go where people know people are all the same. You want to go where everybody knows your name.
I really had to squeeze in a bunch of the people at the end. There's like fucking 40 people, and it mentions all their accounts, and some of them are still around. It mentions Big Dick Barkley, or Incel Barkley, as his original account was, and Daka Daka as, in fact, let's see, Abusive Janeway, Fascist Janeway, as Janeway. Simp Neelix, he's still around. He's fucking, in fact, his tweets are going fucking nuclear a lot lately, which is good. He's worth following for sure. Trad Harry Kim as Kim, and is just Harry Kim being smiling as he's getting phasered into oblivion. Based Gowron, fucking Captain Fraser as Captain Bateson. F Vreenak as Vreenak. Based Row, yeah, I remember her. Emperor Tucker or something. What does this say, actually?
Emperor
Tucker. Hot temp for, oh, Hot Tempered Tucker. Offender Q. Quabby is a fag as Q. Cool Ducat. I remember Cool Ducat. In fact, I think Cool Ducat was one of the people who actually recognized shitty webcomics.
So he's pretty cool.
Yeah. Punished Darheel. Really, I think he was still around. C. It's the letter C. Exocomp. Sexocomp. Was that Exocomp is like a sexual harasser.
Exocomp.
Oh, and there's Morn, of course, which is, I think that guy's still around. All he does is reply with pictures of Morn with no fucking text, which is in character. Just fucking.
Yeah, it's very accurate.
Accurate and classic. What is the, oh no, Janny Anorak says no female changeling. So again, there's still plenty of STBR around, going around, making, and this doesn't even mention Manlet Thorin, who we've done several, if you're watching these and it's like, there's no Manlet Thorin, there have been plenty of previous episodes where we've just done episodes about Manlet Thorin. There are videos on the Subscribestar about Manlet Thorin tweets. In fact, we did some of those where we did a couple episodes about him ratioing Ethan Van Sciver. Just fantastic. Ethan, that shaved a year off Ethan's life. That wraps up Star Treacle, but racist. Manlet Thorin. He follows
the gold,
me.
The magic on those.
The magic on those tapes. Fucking we don't look like assholes right now. Thorin has been knack posting a lot recently. Can't wait for the next non-game to come out for the PlayStation so all these knack cells will stop talking about that instead of knack. So it will stop showing up in my feed as someone quote tweeting, Elf Finder General quote tweeting, Manlet Thorin pointing out, Forspoken, annoying protagonist, casual gameplay, bad graphics, $70. Knack based protagonist, hardcore gamers only, good graphics, knack is the graphics, $20. Promotes goblin genocide, real ones know, smirk. So again, tons of wonderful content. Todd Howard Sigma also showing up here. I think he made a tweet that I put in the notes to be like, here, we could do an episode where we at least go over this. Again, I consider all of these to be comics, technically. It's visuals and text that tell a story. Hey, that's all you need. That's the magic of the comics medium. People don't appreciate that enough. We do, though, because we're patricians. We're patricians. Anyway, so, yeah, that'll wrap it up for now. So, again,
were such patricians, were partitions.
Partitions, even.
And partitions.
Yeah, we're partitions on hard drives. We're like AIs of geniusness. Anyway, so, yeah, if you want more, as always, go order Scribestar. There's just the fucking most top-tier primo kino. Years ahead of our time. Years ahead of your time. Years ahead of everyone's time. On our subscribe star right now, just waiting for you to know it. Knowledge is just sitting there. Are you willing to take it? Are you man enough to take it? So yeah, become a pay pig on our subscribe star to get access to all the bonus videos. Tons of, not just bonus videos, it's the real content is on our subscribe star. And also it supports us. But otherwise, should have listened to Shitty Web Comics.